PC gamers are weirdos, huh? We're a bunch of freaks. We don't know nothing. We're just mad at the PS5 Pro. We're mad at PlayStation, let me tell you, boys. Woo! Yes! Let's go! We're back at it again! Back to back!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. We got another video for you. I'm honestly out of town. I won't be back until Tuesday night. We'll have a video for you guys Wednesday. But I didn't want to leave you with nothing for this week. I wanted to give you guys a little amuse-bouche of the salt that is coming your way for the rest of the week. Because we got our boy, our pal, PorterRock77, back at it again. Saying that PC gamers are always crying about something. And when you see who's actually crying, it's not going to be PC gamers, I'll tell you that right now. But you know what? Let's see what's going to be happening. We're going to be talking about the PS5 Pro, why PC has no exclusives, and pretty much his complete misunderstanding of the entire platform and why everybody likes this thing in the first place. Oh, by the way, you're also going to get really bad ears because his microphone is always blown out 100%. PorterRock, I literally DM'd you the microphone to get and how to set it up, and you still have not done so. You're literally hurting yourself, bro. Literally. And you're hurting everybody else listening to this video. Look, if you want to be the Colt Eastwood of PlayStation, it's time to upgrade that audio, my boy. Just saying.
Welcome, my friends, my family, my fellow gamers. Your only friend is YouTube Streets, PorterRock77, back with another video. And someone please help me out here. Why are PC gamers so mad? Why are they hurting? Why are these PC content creators so upset? It doesn't make sense. Why are they pissed on anything else, especially in console gaming, right? So you got PC content creators talking about, oh, look at PlayStation, now they like Halo. Why do you give why do you care? I can understand the Xbox dudes. Why do you care? Why do you care?
So I have to be honest about this. During this entire video, PorterRock did talk about like Xbox gamers and stuff like that, and I felt that really wasn't appropriate to the conversation because he's talking about PC gamers, so he couldn't even actually stick with his own kind of content or title. Way to go, my boy. Smooth move. The thing is, though, we don't actually care. We've had Halo for the longest time on PC. Halo 1, you know, Combat Evolved, was literally released on PC when it first came out. Halo 2 was also on PC when it first came out. It brought games for Windows Live, if you don't remember that fun time. But the thing is, we don't actually care. What we're doing is we're calling out how hilarious it is that consistently you guys have completely on Halo over and over again, talking about how it's bad, nobody plays it, Halo's dying. I mean, I could pull up any Red Dragon tweet consistently talking about Halo, about the player count and things like that. But the moment that the possibility comes to PlayStation, now all of a sudden you guys are so excited about Halo. Oh, Halo's coming to PlayStation. It's going to be good again. No, no, you never liked Halo. We're just calling out the actual hypocrisy of you wanting to have Halo on your console, not because you're going to play it, not because you're actually going to like Halo, not because, hey, I can finally play Halo on the actual console that I like. You only want Halo on PlayStation to actually have it on a little list war so you can go on Twitter and then talk about it on Twitter, Xbox fanboys about it. We're just calling it out, bro. That's all we're doing, man. Don't get mad that we're calling it out. That's it, baby. That's it.
Especially when you're being a bunch of hypocrites, because PlayStation's reacting to Microsoft the same way you reacted to PlayStation. When PlayStation started putting their games on PC, right, as part of their effort to make more money on their first party titles, you guys did the same thing. Oh, whole slate. Oh, it's coming on PC anyway. Oh, I'll just wait for it to show up on PC. Now that PlayStation gamers are doing the same thing. The same exact thing you guys are doing. The same thing. Oh, Halo's coming on PlayStation. I'll just wait till it comes on PlayStation. Oh, this game's coming on PlayStation. All right. Oh, Indiana Jones. Oh, yeah, I'll just wait for it to come on PlayStation. You guys are upset. So let me get this straight. You're not going to get a PlayStation because the games comes on PC anyway and you're willing to wait. But yet you're telling the PlayStation guys, oh, go get an Xbox console or PC if you really like those games. Make it make sense. And then you try to, you know, talk shit saying, oh, it's all you're only playing on PlayStation because you prefer your plastic box. Isn't PC a plastic box? By you not waiting for these PlayStation games, are you not also choosing your plastic box over the games? The hypocrisy is crazy. And here's the crazy part is, why? Why are you in this? Why are you even in the conversation?
Let's talk about the real difference as to why it's pretty much funny when PC gamer guys do it and not funny when you guys do it. It's basically simple. Since the PS3, dare I say even earlier, everything we've ever heard on the PC side has been, you're a port beggar. You should go ahead and just buy a PS5. Just buy a PS4. We have exclusives. I remember, because I'm autistic, that one time where I actually bought a PS4 because I was getting told by everybody, Alex, buy a PS4 for our games. You're going to love it. Go. And then I streamed playing those games. I hated the PlayStation 4. Why? Because I had to pay for online. I had really bad resolution. I had low frame rates. I had to deal with all the other that came with PlayStation. Pretty much, it was a bad experience overall. And you! Yes, you! I remember! This was like 9 years ago, but I remember. Autism. You even quote tweeted that tweet, and you were saying, like, the power of exclusives. A PC gamer buys a PS4 for the power of exclusives! Yes! Don't forget like I forgot! Because I didn't forget! And that's why we're making fun of you guys. Because the thing is, you don't actually care about playing Xbox games. You don't. There are lots of PC gamers who want to play PlayStation games, but they don't want to spend $500 for a plastic box or a console for one or two games, spend $80 a year for online, have to deal with the entire ecosystem there, spend another $70 for that video game to have just one or two of them, and then have that PS5 sit on a shelf and collect dust the entire time when they're getting a better experience, free online, and having every customizable option they can on the PC. And getting better ports on PC as well, because Nixxis does amazing work. You see, we've been told forever, go get a PlayStation, go get a PS5, go get a PS4, exclusive. And then now that it's coming to PC, we're like, I don't have to buy your box. Sorry. And if you want to get technical, PC isn't a plastic box. I mean, some of them are plastic, but it's mostly an aluminum chassis. It's just a case. It's mostly aluminum. It's not really plastic, so I mean, could tip my fedora on that one for you, buddy.
Y'all upset? I'm gonna tell you why you're upset. You're upset because PlayStation is the clear obstacle that's in the way of what you guys really want. You don't want exclusives because you know when it comes to the big blockbuster exclusives, it's consoles that predominantly dominate that market. The days of PC dominating big market exclusives is gone. We haven't seen that in years. Years. You know, the days of StarCraft, Warcraft, right? Unreal Tournament, when they were exclusives to PC, and then, you know, they became multi-plat ports, whatever. But when PC was at its height, Doom, those games were exclusives. Wolfenstein, they were exclusives for a while, right? Then little by little, as the console market grew, those games started becoming multi-plat because there was this huge console market that's making lots of money. And developers were like, oh yeah, you know.
It's kind of funny how you have no f***ing clue about the PC gaming market whatsoever. Let's take the games you mentioned. StarCraft was on the Nintendo 64. Warcraft was also on the PlayStation under the Tides of Darkness moniker. Yes, you had Warcraft 2 and RTS on PlayStation. Diablo 1 was also on the PS1. Half-Life 1 was on PS2. The Orange Box, Team Fortress 2, Counter-Strike GO, and Half-Life 2, and the expansions were also on PS3 and Xbox 360. Doom was actually on the Super Nintendo. Wolfenstein, not Wolfenstein, was also on the Super Nintendo. The thing is, PC pretty much never had any actual exclusives unless they were purposely designed via the UI to use a keyboard and mouse. And even nowadays, it's even less to happen because developers finally figured out how to use a proper controller to have direct input for a possible keyboard and mouse or even a cursor on the screen. Hell, your DualSense has a touchpad that can be used as a cursor. So in reality, there is no barrier anymore between PC and console. They're both practically the same. And you could even make the argument as well that your consoles are just trimmed down PCs. You still have to install everything. You still have to be connected online. You have updates and patches. You have to deal with all of that kind of stuff. But the thing is, you have to pay for that. We don't have to pay for that. You're basically exactly like a PC right now, except yours trimmed down console that is just a PC, mind you, which is made by AMD. So really, you have PC parts in your console. Just has a PlayStation logo on top of it. mine just has a really cool case instead. And you're literally negating your entire argument while you're talking, saying like, oh, PC had exclusives until they became multi-plat because there was more money in consoles. Just like there's more money in PC now, which is exactly why PlayStation is putting their games on PC. So where's your argument, my boy? Like, what are we talking about here? It's not about that PC had exclusives. It's about that PC had different things that made it more attractive to other kinds of gamers. And that's the difference you can't figure out because you don't know anything about PC gaming. But let's continue.
So unless it was a game that could not possibly be made on console, mostly RTSs because, you know, you need a keyboard, whatever, to play them, they were becoming multiplats, right? So now PC is a multiplat engine. That's pretty much what the platform is. It is a multiplat device, right? Sure, if you buy the right hardware, you buy the right GPU, CPU, you put in, you invest some money, you will get the best versions of those games. But that's pretty much what PC has been relegated to, whatchamacallit, in the gaming space.
Look, bro, I stutter all the time too. I'm not going to make fun of you for that. It's relegated. It's okay. I get tongue-tied too when I'm slamming assholes with my tongue. But look, here's the thing. Let's talk about this, right? Your PS5 has also been relegated to a multi-platform device. The majority of your exclusives are now directly on PC, a vastly different platform. Third-party is what you guys have become. Xbox has been a third-party since the Xbox One era, since Quantum Break came to PC day and date. It's just the way it is, my boy. These companies want to make more money, and they're going to do it by putting their games in more places. That's just how it is. That's how it's going to be. The fact that you can't grasp that and think of that concept is honestly wild to me. And the thing is, you thinking that the only reason why PC gaming is good is because you're going to spend more money to get better graphics and frame rate really goes to show you have no idea why PC gaming is good. Just the fact that we have to pay for online alone should be enough of a window as to why people like gaming on PC. Having different graphical options and settings across every single game that you play is way better than just having performance, ray tracing, or graphics. Why would you want that? And if you're talking about spending money on getting better visuals and better frame rate, you're doing the same thing with the PS5 Pro. You spend $500 on your PS5, hopefully you didn't buy it scalped, then you spend $700 on your PS5 Pro, it's $1,200 already, then we're talking about, what, 4 to 5 years of PlayStation Online? That's $80 a year? We're looking at $320 on top, so you're looking at almost $1,600 that you've spent over 4 years. Just on that one plastic box. Do you know the kind of PC you would have had for that kind of money? You know the kind of experience you would have had for that kind of money. But yet, for some reason, you're talking about PC gaming as if, like, we're the weird ones. But you're the one constantly spending money on a platform just because of the logo on the box. Not about your actual experience. And you know what? Let's go ahead and pull a this you, because we have to at this point. Here you are talking about moving to PC gaming because not having to pay for online while getting to play with everyone and still getting trophies on Helldivers 2. Take a look.
Cosplay, that's not the point. The point is, they have access to the PlayStation audience with no extra charge. You see the dark territory? You see the dark path this leads? That's why if Sony goes day and day, the reason why I'm not going to PlayStation, not because I'm butthurt or whatever, is because I don't want to get... Why would I buy a PlayStation knowing what they're going to do? I get everything, plus better versions, plus free multiplayer. I don't get screwed over in any way. And that's exactly what happens on Xbox the moment they went day and day. You have to pay for Gears on Xbox, but that same game, which runs much better, looks much better, and you can play with a keyboard if you choose to, is free. And you still play with the Xbox guys. And I'm like, yo, I see the message on the wall, bro. Like, how can it make sense that you're paying extra money to the platform holder and get worse? Across everything, literally. The game, you get the worst version. And you have to pay extra just to play a portion of it online. That's not cool. You see what I'm saying?
Yo, you got a point, man. You got a point.
That's why if PlayStation goes down this path for day and date on PC, cool. Make that money, cool. But you're not going to screw me over in the process. Nah, dog. We're going to be on PC and I ain't got to worry about that. I'll still get all the PlayStation games. I'll still enjoy all the PlayStation games day and date. And I don't have to worry about none of that subscription. That's done. That's over with. Am I right?
So where'd the Switch come from, my guy? Where's the flip-flop? What happened? Why is it that all of a sudden you're like, wait a minute, you see the dark path and where this leads. Oh boy, all these games are coming day and date on PC, but now randomly a few months later, oh, your platform's trash because of the Pro. Bro, what happened? Look, do yourself a favor. Hit the link in the description down below. Get yourself a StarForge PC and let go of this. Your brother already let go. It's time for you to let go too.
And that pisses you guys off because consoles, right, was getting exclusives until Microsoft bowed out. The moment Microsoft bowed out and said, hey, we're going to put our games day and date on PC because they failed to be a console market provider. Their console wasn't selling, meaning they're not generating the revenue needed. So they needed PC as part of their strategy. Once you guys got a taste of that, now you wanted all the platforms to do that, right? And any platform, right, that still holds on to this fundamental idea of, hey, a console is important, we still got to do things for the console, you guys are just bashing it and bashing any fan base that supports it, even though you look ridiculous. I mean, though you look absolutely stupid doing it. And that's what it's all about.
Portarock, even by your own logic, then Sony has failed as well in the console industry. Because if they were truly being successful, they wouldn't need to put their games on PC at all. They wouldn't need the extra money that we provide them on a consistent basis. They would have stayed exclusive on their console specifically. So it's not about, oh, we're mad at the whole thing about PlayStation not doing it. We're just scratching our heads like, what's the difference? The games are going to come either way. You made an app for the DualSense Edge on our PC. You gave us full DualSense functionality on Steam for every single feature that this controller has on Steam. You gave us the ability to have trophy support, gave us PSN logins, had everything supplied to us directly. You even restricted sales of over 180 countries because you wanted to enforce that login. So they're giving us literally every single thing that we could ever ask for except the one last thing that's left. It's the last straw for you. Like you said before, you know where this dark path leads, the dark territory where it goes. Your own words. It's not about getting angry about it. It's more like, what's the difference? Why are you waiting? Because all you have right now is a timed exclusivity box. You don't have an exclusive console. What you have is a console that has timed exclusives that then comes to PC later on that we pay less money for, have a better experience for, have a complete game for, and don't have to pay for online and get all the support that you get on top of that right now. We may have to wait a year, but it shows up. So really the question is, why wait the year? Because it's a stupid thing to do. If you want more sales, they could just market the fact that both PC and PS5 are going to be getting the game at the same time. And honestly, you're going to be contradicting yourself later on in this video directly because of that.
You guys don't like the idea. You guys hate the idea of the PS5 Pro. You absolutely hate it. And it isn't because of saving money. You guys don't give about that. Shut the hell up. Thinking that you are the purveyors and protectors of the consumer. Just shut up. Take that keyboard. Shove it up your butt. No one's believing on you. You hate the PS5 Pro because of what it truly stands for. And what it truly stands for is Sony cares about the console. They're trying to make consoles better, and they will keep investing technologies into their console. And you know that's contrary to the, oh, put everything everywhere concept. You know that's a complete different strategy. So as long as Sony keeps pushing these consoles, pushing these new innovative technologies, keep trying to push console gaming forward, you know you're not going to get your day and date strategy. You guys know it.
Bro, day and date is already here. Like, I don't know if you haven't realized that yet. It's only a matter of a few games that aren't having it right now, which is honestly shocking you haven't figured that out. Until Dawn Remake, that was day and date. Concord, day and date. Lego Horizon, that's day and date on Switch, PC and PS5. Helldivers 2, that was day and date. I mean, that was just this year off the top of my head. It's already there, bro. How do you not see this right now? Again, they've done everything they possibly can to make it easy for PC gamers to then buy their games and play their games. But the problem is you just don't get it. The thing is, we don't hate the PS5 Pro for what it stands for. We hate the PS5 Pro because you guys think it's a 4090. Some of you do. In fact, on your own podcast, that Craig guy said it was a 4090 or better. And you called him out saying I was going to get him. And I did. How do you not figure this out yet, bro? And we are the purveyors of all things right. Because the thing is, people like you will bend over, touch your toes, and spread your cheeks open for anybody on PlayStation and put that DualSense right up your butt. Because the thing is, all you care about is the logo on the box. If you actually cared, you would have said, wait a minute, Sony, why are you charging me $700 for this console. The PS5 should be like $299 or $349 at the most right now. The PS5 Pro should be $499. What happened to the price drops? We're 4 years into the generation. You haven't dropped the price once? What's going on? And if you're going to spend $800 after you get the disc tray and the console itself to play your physical games, because if you're a hardcore PlayStation gamer, you're going to spend the extra money on the physical disc tray. If you're spending over $800 already, you're already so close to the $1,000 mark. What's stopping you from getting on PC? That's the argument we're making. If you're going to spend $800 on a console to get slightly better graphics, to get PSSR, which is just FSR4, because FSR4 already exists, it's going to be coming out soon, then what are we doing here, bro? You're literally right there on the cusp of what you need to get a PC that would honestly demolish every console you ever had. But for some reason, you don't think of it that way. You think of it like, oh, they're so great. They're pushing the console forward. We're saying, no, bro. You're getting and you don't see it. Because you care more about the stupid logo on the box than you do about your actual experience playing the game. Your brother figured it out. DocDark1985, there's levels to this, figured it out. You haven't figured it out yet? What are we doing?
Even the recent rumor now of Nixis, right? Some of you PC dudes, if you guys aren't aware, apparently Nixis is almost done porting, and what Sony's going to do with them now is now they're going to have them focus on remakes and remasters of older games instead of continuing to port. A lot of PC dudes were projecting that once these ports were done, they were going to put them on to new projects so they could start doing day-and-day games. That was the prediction by these PC gamers, and it seems like they're wrong. It seems like Nixis will now focus on remasters and remakes of older titles, Vice being put on the new project so they could do day-and-day PC. So again, this completely goes against what PC Gamer wants. PC Gamer wants day-and-day games from PlayStation. They want PlayStation to do what Microsoft already did. And it looks like they're not getting that. So now they're just lashing out with just stupidity, saying stupid. That is hypocritical. Straight hypocrisy.
So, bro, here's the funniest thing about all of this. Nixis did the remaster for Horizon Zero Dawn. It's coming day and date to PC and PS5. You know that, right? So if the remasters and remakes that Nixis is going to be focusing on, because they were purchased as a PC porting studio, what if those remasters and remakes also come day and date to PC and PS5? What are you going to say then? If that happens, what are you going to say then? What goalpost are you going to shift at that moment in time? Oh, it's an old game. It's a remaster. It's a remake. Bro, what are we doing here? You're setting yourself up. Because if that happens, if that occurs, the person looking stupid is going to be you. Because PlayStation has other companies and developers making those PC ports for their games. Jetpack Studios. They did the God of War port. Just because Nixis isn't doing it doesn't mean those ports aren't happening or that day and date won't occur. Like, that's so completely illogical across the board. Because you know what? If Nixis makes those remasters and remakes, because we're getting Horizon Zero Dawn remaster on PC day and date, like I said before, and if those are day and date on PC of those old games, if God of War 1, 2, and 3 come to PC, day and date, from Nixis as a remaster, and it's the PS3 version. Look, if it's this version and it hits PC day and date, what are you gonna say? What are you gonna do? Tell me, because that's gonna go against everything you've said in the video. But we'll see. Time will tell. Even though we've already seen games going day and date to PC from PlayStation, it's only a matter of time. It's only a couple of handful of games that are left. You have a timed exclusivity console. Your console has no exclusives. They're all timed. And the fact that you haven't seen that, that's the real part that's disappointing. That's what's disappointing.
So they're pissed off that PlayStation gamers are like, oh, Microsoft is supporting PlayStation? Okay, cool. You know, I'll get their games on PlayStation. Whatever game I like, I'll play it on PlayStation. I'll wait. And they're mad. Even though they're doing the same thing when it comes to PlayStation. Oh, PlayStation's putting games on PC? Oh yeah, I'll wait 2 years. I'll wait 3 years to play that. There's no reason for me to get a PlayStation to play this game. It's eventually going to come to PC anyway. It's the same logic. The same exact thing. But yet, it's wrong for PlayStation gamers to do that. But it's cool for PC gamers. Oh, I get it. Oh, you don't understand. PC gamers don't live by exclusives. Because you don't have a choice. You act like that's a choice. There's a difference between having a platform that pushes the best exclusives, right? But you still say, ah, it's not that important. That's a choice. When you actually get it, but you still reject it, choice. When you don't get it at all, you can't say, well, I didn't get it for this reason. You didn't have a choice.
You want to talk about choice? You don't have a choice. You know why? Here. That's why. You don't have a choice, bro. Again, your console has zero exclusives. They're all timed. You don't have a choice. They're not pushing the best exclusives on your console. They're not. They're pushing all those multiplats onto PC. That's what you haven't figured out yet. Just because you're getting a PS5 Pro doesn't mean that all of a sudden you're going to keep exclusives on your console forever. We know that's not the case. This ain't the PS2 anymore, bro. That era is done. Sony wants as much money as possible. They're going to keep putting their games onto PC. If they didn't, they wouldn't be giving us all the support that they're giving us right now. That would have never happened in the first place. Remember, it went from never ever. Remember, never ever. To, oh, it'll never be God of War. It'll never be Spider-Man. To, oh, it's every 2 years. It's every 4 years. Oh, no, now it's every two. Oh, no, now it's every year. Oh, no, it's only the live service games. Oh, it's only the remakes and remasters. Where is the line going to be pushed to next, bro? I want to know. We moved the line so many times that you guys have forgot where the line started in the first place. You don't have a choice. You lost that choice. You were never given the choice. The reason we're making fun of you isn't because you're saying the same thing that we said. The reason we're making fun of you is because you were on Xbox games continuously, and then now you're celebrating getting Xbox games. That's the thing that's hypocritical. That's what we're making fun of you for. That's why we said, hey, look, you shouldn't be saying that at all, because honestly, for the last 40 years plus, you were saying Xbox games are dog. You were. You've said those words. Xbox is dog, right? But now Halo's coming to PlayStation. Now you're pumped. Even though this is you saying you bought Game Pass for $1 to play Halo Infinite, you got your fill, right? So apparently Game Pass works. You never had a choice. And you're pretending like you do.
And I refuse to believe your bullshit. Because I know there is no gamer on the entire planet, not one gamer on the entire planet, that has a preferred platform. And if their preferred platform has an amazing exclusive, they will reject it. Not one. You're all lying on that one. Don't even come with that. If whatever platform you prefer to play on, if that platform provider ended up giving you exclusives, you will love it because you are not missing out. You are getting some amazing games on the platform you prefer, whether it's PC, Xbox, Nintendo, PlayStation. It could be the goddamn Booster Roy cloud service. Wherever you prefer to play, if somehow you got the added bonus of amazing exclusives, you would love it. No rational gamer in the entire universe would be upset over that. So stop lying.
Again, bro, the only thing you care about is having a list war for your plastic box. Half-Life Alyx should be on PSVR 2, without a doubt. World of Warcraft should be on PlayStation and it should be on Xbox. So many PC games should not be stuck on PC because there's no need for them to be stuck there anymore. The UIs can all be fixed. You don't need mouse and keyboard for every single game anymore. Game developers know how to work around a controller now and provide you with a good experience on a controller. You know how bad it would have been for Baldur's Gate 3 to only be on PC? I want everybody to enjoy video games. I don't care about what box is the game is on. It doesn't matter to me. I don't care about exclusives because I have exclusives you'll never have. You want to know what they are? Free online, mods, full customization, free games, lower prices. I don't have to worry about, oh, my toy, my box has games you'll never have, because that's not important to me. What's important to me is I'm not bent over f***ing company and corporation and then f***ed every single time and told to smile and enjoy it and then turn around and say, thank you, sir, can I have another? We're not here for that, bro. We're sitting here going, hey, PlayStation, you tried to restrict Helldivers 2 to all these countries. F*** off. And they reversed it. Then they went ahead and say, oh, PSN is required. And it turns out it's not. So what are we doing, bro? We don't care about who gets to play what game. I want people to play every game. Every game should be on every platform. How you haven't figured that out yet is shocking to me. Because you know what? You don't talk to PC gamers. You don't. You talk to PlayStation fanboys who think they know what PC gaming is, or who say they have a 4090 when they really don't. That's who you talk to.
Listen, PC cucks. You're looking stupid for no reason. For no reason. Especially like, you know, this is not the same, right? A gamer who prefers console most likely won't make the jump to PC, just like a gamer who prefers PC most likely won't make the jump to console. Sure, you might have gamers that play on both, right? But they generally, you know, stay in their lanes and stuff like that. You guys are getting upset over nothing.
There it is. Remember when I told you that you were going to contradict yourself in this video? There is the contradiction right there. You're talking about how PlayStation is pushing the console, yet you've admitted directly, right in front of everyone, that PC gamers will not move to console gaming. And console gamers will not move to PC. By your own logic, if that is the case, by what you're saying, then there is no reason for PlayStation to not go day and date. Because at that same moment in time, you are admitting to everyone, we are not going to buy a console for a couple of games. It is literally wasting PlayStation's time to restrict that by everybody, because it's not going to impact the sales of your console, because console gamers won't move to PC, and PC gamers aren't moving to console. The contradiction, you alone have done it directly in your own video by your own words, bro. The biggest self-snitch I've ever seen. And you had the audacity to call people PC cucks. Bro, the only cuck around here is you, PlayStation cuck. Because even then, every statement you made has now been completely contradicted by that last statement on this video. It's wild to me how you didn't think about that and said, oh shit, that totally negated everything I said. That literally exposes me for why PlayStation should put their games day and date on PC. Because PC gamers aren't gonna buy the console. And console gamers aren't gonna buy the PC. So what's the difference? And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Again, fanboys getting angry about PC gamers for no particular reason whatsoever. Just because they think that they have exclusives on their box, when in reality, it's just timed exclusivity. And PlayStation is just wasting their time not putting their games on PC day and date, because just like Porter Rock said, PC gamers aren't gonna move to console. Yet, for some reason, he feels like they're still gonna push their console, even though they are, and that's perfectly fine. Xbox is gonna do something else entirely too. That's perfectly fine. The thing is though, stop sitting here and talking about how great a company is when all that company wants to do is take your money. And you're falling for it hook, line, and sinker. And you're taking everything they do as some sort of like badge of honor to like wave around in front of everyone as if you like, you made the right decision. Bro, it's a toy, it's a plastic box. It's just made to play video games. It's not that deep. It really isn't. Every game should be on every platform. And I haven't figured out why people are against that for some reason. It's wild to me. Absolutely wild. But ladies and gentlemen, if you liked today's video, thank you. If you didn't like it, fuck you. If you want to see more of this kind of content, more PC port reviews, gaming news, Steam Deck videos, as well as live streams every Saturday night, 8:45 p.m. Eastern, subscribe to the channel. We're on our way to 75K, and I want to say thank you guys so very much. I'm actually out of town right now. I pre-recorded this over the weekend. I'll be back Wednesday morning with more content for you, and we'll go from there. Now, to add on top of that, if you want to join the Discord or have access during emotes for live streams, Saturday nights, 8:45 p.m. Eastern, become a YouTube member. It's as low as a dollar. If you don't want to spend a buck, don't sweat it. Come on down to the stream anyways. Chat is insane, and they run the entire show. Believe me, it's a great time. Now, with all that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Stop. It's time.
answer. It's time to stop. It's time to stop, Kenny. No more. What the fuck are your parents? It's time to stop. It's time to stop, Kenny. No more. What the fuck are your parents? Just stop. Just stop. Stop.